I'm home. Oh my gosh.
Keep it 100, I'd rather you trust me than to keep it a whole 100. Don't got you, I got nothing. I got something. Hold up.
Hi writers, it's Raya. Welcome back to my motherfucking channel, and it is Friday, guys. It's Friday, and I know you're probably really, really excited. And the only thing different about this video is, A, I have on no makeup, and that is for a reason, because this is going to be a story that I told you guys. I was talking about my best friend from elementary school once I felt like I'm ready, and I feel like I'm a little ready, so we're going to try it until there's no music playing, because there are some things that are joking in this video, but it's a really serious video. But before we get into the story time, let's get the writer popping. This is gonna be my writer for the week. He hit me up on Snapchat, and he did it like right as soon as my video dropped from the other story time, so I was able to screenshot his pic. Here he is, and tell him he was gonna be the writer, because yeah, like, if you gotta get some, you gotta be on it. You gotta get on it fast, but let's get it with him. Into the video, if you are not already subscribed to my channel and this is your first time watching one of my videos, hit that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up, and stick around for more story times from me. You could also binge watch all my story times. The link to the playlist for all my story times is down below. You could never miss it. It's gonna always be in that description, okay? This weekend, Saturday or Sunday, and let's get into the video. Okay, a lot of you guys, I alluded to a story about my best friend from elementary school, and so then I'm just gonna tell you about our friendship, and I'm gonna tell you what happened to her. So a lot of you guys know that I left Spencer at the end of fourth grade year, or no, fifth, no, I left Spencer at the end of fourth grade year, went to Avon fifth grade, and then moved to East Orange with my mother for sixth grade. I ended up going back to Louise A. Spencer in seventh grade. And I knew most of the people, I knew half of the people there because we grew up in the project together, but a lot of the people I did not know, and you guys have seen the story times where I was bullied. But I had a really good group of friends, one in particular, we're gonna call her Stacy. I didn't always look like this. I looked like this, but I wasn't always this, if you catch what I'm saying. Like, embracing me. And now Stacy was so, so pretty. She had like a nice shape, and she was friends with everybody. So she basically just like befriended me. Like, the first couple of days of school, she didn't know me. She was just really, really nice, and we just became really, really close. Like, she was so beautiful. I thought, you know how you like admire somebody in your life, you think they're like super gorgeous, and she was really, really smart. She just didn't have the best life at home, which is usually the case with a lot of people. Me and Stacy got extremely close. It was me, Stacy, and I know Nikki wouldn't mind, and Nikki. we were really, really close all of seventh grade year. And the beginning to half of eighth grade year. Now, during this time, Stacy would come and sit down over my house a lot. Stacy got to know my mother a lot. Her and my mother were really, really close, because like I said, Stacy had issues at home with her mom and her stepfather. Her mother wasn't really there a lot, and her stepfather was there in a way that you don't want a stepfather to be there. So she spent a lot of nights at my house. She stayed a weekend a lot. And that's how we got really, really close. She had been staying over my house like every single weekend. And I was like kind of wondering like why she was staying over my house every single weekend. And she had ended up telling me that her stepfather was doing things to her that she didn't want. How Stacy was literally built like a grown woman. She had a popping ass shape. She was beautiful. She was super, super nice. She was super goofy. She was super funny. Oh my God. And so she told me that, and she asked me not to tell anybody, but I was 13, and I felt like it was a lot for her to be going through, and it was a lot for her to tell me. So I ended up telling my mother, and my mother always runs her mouth like all the time. Okay. So I ended up telling my mother, and she ended up telling her mother, and then her mother ended up like fighting her and like putting her out because she didn't believe her. But her stepfather had been like touching her for a long time, and it had just got like really, really bad. So my mother told her mother ended up fighting her, and she ended up kicking her out. And so Stacy was like really, really mad at me. She was like, really, really mad at me because I had said something to my mother, but I didn't know what else to do. And so like she stopped talking to me. And so we didn't talk for a while. And before we stopped talking, we were like looking for like prom dresses because we were like gonna graduate together, of course, 8th grade, and go to prom. We're supposed to go to prom with each other. Like, this was my best friend. And we ended up stopped talking over that. And like, I remember when we got to prom, she had like the same color dress as me, and it was similar. And like, we were like fighting over that, like not fist fighting or anything like that. We're arguing over that. It was just like the stupidest thing to argue about. But our friendship ended over me telling my mother, and then it stayed ended because we were arguing over who got the dress first and who copied somebody's dress, and it was the stupidest shit in life. But okay, so fast forward, we graduate, I don't talk to her. I think I gave her a hug at graduation. My mother was there. She was like, oh my god, this is so ugly. My mother was there, and she was like, you guys are like arguing. I mean, y'all are better than this. Like, y'all are good friends. Like, y'all need to make up. And we hugged each other, and we were like, oh, we'll do better. We'll make up. But we never ended up talking again. And then so fast forward, like, she went to Shabazz. And this is, I went to private school my freshman year. And then she ended up having like a lot of fights at Shabazz with the girls. So she ended up transferring to East Orange campus. And then so I'm home. Oh my gosh. And so I'm home one day. My mother come home. She got a newspaper in her hand. And she's like, Mariah. She's like, Mariah, I think this is Stacy. This is something that happened to Stacy. So I'm like, what? And I read the paper, and the paper says, they identified a 14-year-old girl's body. And they said her name in the paper, that it was her. And so I'm like, no, like, it can't be. So like, I call her mom like 10 times. Her mother is not answering. And then I want to say that I called Shaniqua. It was one of our friends from elementary school. I called, and they're like crying. Yeah, it's her. Yeah, it's her. The paper says that somebody like took her and like raped her, like beat her up, shot her in the face. And I feel so like stupid because like the last time we like talked to each other, it was like stupid. Like, you know how you like have a stupid fight with somebody, and like you always wonder like if that's gonna be like the last time that you talk to them? And I never thought that it would be, and it was. And I feel like shit. I felt like shit. I know I was young, and I know we were both like 13, 14, but like, I told like a big secret that she asked me not to tell, and then we were fighting over a stupid fucking dress. And then like she got murdered, and it's like so annoying. And we had to, I said, go to her funeral, and it's so sad. It's so sad because like who does that? Like who actually takes a young, like that is like real life. Like you can get taken and you can get raped and you can get beat up and you can get killed, like, and that's real life. And that shit is crazy to me. Like I don't care how much she looked at like an adult. I don't care if you were talking, I don't care if she was talking to you and lied about her age, to do all that stuff to her. Like he did so much stuff to her. Like she couldn't even have an open casket, that's how much stuff he did to her. And I feel like a dumb ass kid for having a dumb ass kid argument with somebody who was so close. She was like my sister. She was like my sister. And I'm like annoyed that like I would like never see her again. I literally think about it every day. Like I literally think about it every single day. She was like my friend when like I didn't have that many friends. Like it was just me, her, and Nikki. Like she was so, we were so close. She was literally there for, like I told her everything, and she never told any of my secrets ever, like not one. She was always there for me, and I just felt like I just super let her down by telling my mother. Like if I didn't tell my mother, would we still be friends? But then her stepfather would still be touching her, because he stopped touching her because her mother put her out. So she was just everywhere, she just was never home. But like so many things that I just think about, but I think about her every day. And that's why I'm always so cautious, and I'm cautious with my cousins and my sisters. Like I don't want anything to happen to them, because that could like literally happen so quick, and like you can't do anything about it. Like when a grown ass man is physically taking you somewhere, physically doing things to you that you can't stop, and you can't, you have to be like super careful. And I knew I was gonna cry so much when I told this story, because I love her so much, and I literally think about her every single day. It's like not a day that goes by that I don't think about her, and like it's not a day that goes by that I don't think about what happened to her. And and this is the first time I actually talked about it since her funeral. Like I never talk about it. Like I never talk about it because I don't like crying. It's so ugly and my face is hurting and it's hot. My eyes are red. I can't, like, okay, yeah. So that's the story time for this weekend. This year, this week, you guys get what I'm saying. So now you guys know what happened to my best friend. I literally, like, I don't want to talk about the story anymore. I love you guys much, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.